Hello, my friends. I'm back. So today I want to talk again about one of my favorite shows of all time, Community. I've talked about this show a lot in the past, but the more I watch it, the more I realize that I've just got more stuff to say about it. So I'm gonna do it, because nobody's listening anyway. So in a previous video, I talked about why the characters in this show work so well together, but now I want to talk about a different aspect of them, their arcs, and specifically, the subtlety with which the show presents them. In order to give an example of what I'm talking about, I'm going to start by comparing two episodes that deal with similar themes, one from Community, and another from another show that I really like, How I Met Your Mother. The episodes are Season 2, Episode 16 of Community, Intermediate Documentary Filmmaking, and Season 6, Episode 19 of How I Met Your Mother, Legend Daddy. In both of these episodes, we see our main characters dealing with the idea of reconnecting with their respective fathers. In How I Met Your Mother, Barney is having dinner with his father after not seeing him for almost 30 years, and is trying to cope emotionally with the idea of reconnecting with him. In Community, Pierce is faking his death and tells Jeff that he has tracked down his father, who he also hasn't seen for 30 years, when really he hasn't, all in the interest of one last act of psychological torture. Yeah, this show is pretty weird. Now, both of these episodes have a pretty substantial amount of buildup to their respective climaxes. That sounds weird. I didn't mean it to sound like that. It's not like that. I mean like the emotional climax. For the buildup to both of these emotional climaxes, we get Barney having dinner with his dad, and in Community, we get this gem of an interaction.
Your dad or Pierce?
There is no dad. Get this thing out of my face! And don't you dare intercut this with footage of me freaking out.
Now, I want to show you the emotional climax of both of these shows, because it's really important to the point I'm trying to make, but for time's sake, I'm going to edit them both down to just the important parts. First, in How I Met Your Mother, we see Barney confront his dad outside, and he finally confronts him about being abandoned as a child.
JJ gets a childhood, a dad, a real family, and a basketball hoop? No, I at least get the hoop. I'm taking it with me.
Please, just come down and talk to me.
Why should I? You're lame, okay? You're just some lame suburban dad.
Why does that make you so mad?
Because if you were gonna be some lame suburban dad, why couldn't you have been that for me?
Look, Barney, I know I screwed up.
Oh, screwed up doesn't even begin to describe...
I know!
And then in Community, we see Jeff confronting Pierce over cheating him out of seeing his real father.
Hello?
Jeffrey, this is your father.
Uh-huh.
It's me, here in the sedan. You see? I'm waving. I'm sorry I can't come any closer, my boy. This is too difficult. You look too much like your mother. No, don't come closer, as you were. Well, I have to catch a flight to Kathmandu, but I just wanted to say cheers to the new friends that you made. They're your true family now.
Now, at first glance, I think most people would say that the scene from How I Met Your Mother tackles the subject matter better. And while I would agree that on its own, it does pack a more powerful emotional punch, but I would argue that it's also more poorly written. Characters on television are supposed to be, at least to an extent, a reflection of real people in our world. But in the real world, this doesn't happen. People don't just come to a big emotional conclusion while shouting at someone and then have a sudden moment of clarity. It's not realistic, that's not how it works. So while this scene is emotional, it isn't genuine, which is why it feels just a little bit off. Alternatively, Community handles this interaction differently. Yes, there's this big show of emotion, but it feels more grounded. Jeff isn't trying to connect his actions to some childhood trauma in the moment, he's just feeling emotionally overwhelmed and releases it. The moment of emotional clarity doesn't come until later, when he has the benefit of hindsight to reflect on the situation. You know, how, like, normal people act. My long-winded point here is that where How I Met Your Mother goes for the over-the-top approach, Community chooses to address these themes in a much more subtle way. How I Met Your Mother chooses to scream its message at the audience, while Community has faith in them to understand the emotional subtext. Trusting your audience to understand the motivations for your characters without directly telling them can be hard, but if the writing is good enough, like it is here, it provides a much more rich experience. Another example of this can be seen in my second favorite character, Mr. Troy Barnes. Now, the first time I watched this show, I watched all of the episodes out of order, and let me tell you, I didn't like Troy at all. I didn't care for him. I would watch episodes from different seasons, and he'd act completely differently. I understood that he was changing because of his friendship with Abed, but to me, it seemed like too drastic a change with too little explanation. And then I watched the show in order, and realized that Troy actually has the best written arc in the entire show. He starts as this stereotypical dumb jock, but then slowly, through his friendship with Abed and everyone else, he opens himself up and embraces his childish side. In one of the outros from season 2, Abed is pulling a prank on him and makes him think that he's somehow transported into a painting.
Abed?
I made it through. I'm a cartoon now.
That's impossible.
Nothing's impossible in here. Animals can talk, your heart is shaped like a heart, and the smell of pie can make you float. You have to believe, Troy. Wait, you don't have to believe.
I didn't.
This guy wouldn't have engaged with this for one second, but through the show, we see him change and grow in realistic and believable ways. They never shout at us, "Hey, look at me, I'm learning to embrace my childish side," because they don't have to. We can understand the arc without it being shoved down our throats, which is something that not very many sitcoms can pull off. In conclusion, I just want to say that while I do really like shows like How I Met Your Mother, I think that when you train your audience to only recognize character development when it's being literally shouted at them, that can really hurt you in the long run, because you always have to find a way to one-up yourself. But when you focus on showing character arcs more subtly, it's not only more sustainable, but ultimately more fulfilling.